Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we solved some questions related to the midpoint theorem. Today, we will discuss some facts related to that. Friends, you may recall, in the previous video, we proved that the quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints of any quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So, will the quadrilaterals formed by joining the midpoints of a trapezium, a square, a rectangle, a rhombus be parallelograms? Let's find out. Friends, look at this trapezium ABCD. Will the quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints of its sides be a parallelogram? In quadrilateral ABCD, if we draw a diagonal AC, then we will get two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Friends, in triangle ABC, point R and point S are the midpoints of sides AB and BC respectively. If we use the midpoint theorem here, then the line segment RS will be parallel to side AC and half in length of side AC. Similarly, in triangle ADC, we can use the midpoint theorem and say that TQ is parallel to side AC and half its length. Friends, look at equations 1 and 2. Now we can say that RS is parallel and equal to TQ. And we know that if a pair of opposite sides of any quadrilateral is parallel and equal, then it is a parallelogram. Therefore, RSQT is a parallelogram. Friends, the second quadrilateral DEFG is a square. Will the quadrilateral LMNO formed by joining its midpoints also be a parallelogram? Yes. Here too, by making the diagonal DF, we can get two triangles DEF and DGF. You can also make the diagonal GE. And by using the midpoint theorem in both the triangles, we can say that LM is parallel and equal to ON. Therefore, quadrilateral LMNO will be a parallelogram. Friends, look at this quadrilateral carefully. Will this be a square? Pause the video with the help of a scale and a protractor. Find the measurement of its sides and angles. You will see that this is also a square. Similarly, try yourself for the rectangle and rhombus and come to a conclusion with the help of your classmates and teachers. Let's look at one more question. In the given figure, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. In which point E and point F are the midpoints of sides BC and DC respectively? And point G is the midpoint of diagonal AC. Based on the given information, state the options that are correct. Friends, let's check the first option. Look at the triangle ACB in the figure. Point E and point G are the midpoints of sides BC and AC respectively. Therefore, according to the midpoint theorem, side GE is parallel to side AB and is half its length. That is, we can write it this way. Friends, you can see that our first option is correct. Now we shall look at the second option. We are given that ABCD is a parallelogram. So sides AD and BC will be equal. And point E is the midpoint of side BC. Therefore, BE will be equal to EC. We can write BC in this way. We can substitute EC in place of BE. Friends, you can see that we get AD equal to 2EC. That is, the second option is also correct. Now let's look at the third option. Friends, this is quite easy. Pause the video and check it yourself. We are given that ABCD is a parallelogram and the opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. But both these sides are adjacent sides. If these would be equal, then quadrilateral ABCD would have been a rhombus, which is not the case. Therefore, this option is incorrect. Friends, that's all in today's session. Today we discussed some facts related to the midpoint theorem. See you in the next video. Thank you.